Why Meghan Markle and Prince Harry's latest moves are no coincidence. Meghan Markle and Prince Harry have made their stance clear when it comes to how they feel about the tabloids. However, their recent actions of being photographed in Los Angeles have one self-proclaimed die-hard defender of the couple questioning their motives behind everything. During an appearance on the British show this morning, Robert Rinder, host of the British reality courtroom series Judge Rinder, provided some insight into what the duo could be trying to achieve. "I've been for a long time one of the last die-hard defenders of Meghan and Harry, and certainly Meghan," he said, according to The Sun. "Just to be clear, the timing of this is no coincidence," he said of Meghan and Harry delivering food and essentials on behalf of the charity project Angel Food. "They are, for anybody who are court geeks as I am, they will know they are about to have a hearing in a case they're bringing against the newspapers," Rinder continued. "This stuff would have emerged, so they are strategically putting their evidence into the public sphere. I'm afraid to say it's harder to think of a more clear articulation, a split, between a generation that is me, enough about me what you do think of me? Where you accidentally use the press when you want them, but get rid of them when you don't," he elaborated. "You find yourself photographed delivering food to the poor, one wonders how that happened, vis-a-vis the service and the sacrifice of our Queen, whose birthday it is today, and other royals. It's becoming increasingly difficult to defend their position," the 41-year-old added. Meghan and Harry have been in Los Angeles practicing social distancing and doing their part to help those in need as the world takes on COVID-19. Reports have explained that the former actress has started to feel back to her normal self since relocated back to California. For Prince Harry, though, that seems to be a different story. During an episode of the Royals podcast, royal expert Angela Mollard spilled that the move was a lot tougher on the red-headed royal. "I very much think that Harry will be suffering from irrelevancy," she dished. "Right now, the world is not focused on them. He can't do the work that he wants to do. He is separated from his family at a time when the rest of the world is using Zoom or WhatsApp to chat with each other. He must feel very separate. He doesn't have friends in LA, she does," Mollard continued. "She has Doria, she has her family. While Meghan might have been feeling equally as removed when she lived in the UK, for Harry, friends and his brother have been the people that have supported him through the years since his mother's death. To have that stripped away, I think, will be very discombobulating for him," she added. Prince Harry mystery, bizarre background in Harry's video call sends Twitter into meltdown. A bizarre coincidence in the video background of Prince Harry's latest video message from Los Angeles has sent the internet into meltdown and even sparked a Twitter hashtag. Earlier this week, Prince Harry released a video message for Well Child, a charity he has been a long-term patron of in its support for seriously ill children. However, viewers picked up on a bizarre mystery found in the background of the 30-minute conversation with carers and parents. Viewers online speculate that the video background Harry was using for his virtual conversation was the exact same as the background seen behind Harry nearly a month ago. This has led several commentators to speculate that Harry and Meghan moved to Los Angeles far earlier than previously suspected. The mystery behind the background even sparked a trending Twitter hashtag of #WhereShy. Speaking on ITV's Royal Rota, royal correspondent Chris Shipp discussed the background of the video message with royal expert Lizzie Robinson. Shipp said, "Behind Prince Harry, when he did this video message for Well Child, was he doing it from LA or Canada? Where was he?" He added, "It looked very similar to where he did a video message before when we all thought he was in Canada, but now he is in LA." Robinson added, "Twitter was very observant when the video went up and they noticed the background was similar. I suppose they moved to LA a lot sooner than any of us realized." Shipp jumped in, "That's what I took from it too. Either they picked up the kitchen and moved into Los Angeles, or they were already in Los Angeles when it was all happening." Twitter users remarked on the similarity in the visual background for Harry's message to Well Child and his message to the Invictus Games athletes in March. It had previously been suggested that Harry and Meghan had moved to California from Vancouver just prior to the U.S. coronavirus lockdown. However, The mysterious background has prompted wild speculation online. One user said, "Remember to vary the background of your videos so we can believe you are in Canada or LA, it's the same place, same background as supposedly Canada." Another observed, "We were told Harry was in Canada when he recorded a video to postpone Invictus. He is in the same room for today's recorded video for Well Child, but we are told he is in LA. Where is he? LA? Canada? Or maybe he never left the UK?" The bizarre mystery comes as Prince Harry's close friend, famed conservationist Dr. Jane Goodall, revealed that the Duke of Sussex was finding his new life in California a bit challenging.